Welcome back to Demystifying Season 2. In case you're just tuning in, this is not a cosplay. We are here celebrating all things agents that we announced at Build. And joining me is our friend Jack, the Copilot Studio Marketing Lead. Jack, are you ready to answer the next question submitted by the Dynamics community?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. The next question submitted is, when would you use a Copilot to automate a task? And when would you use a traditional flow? And can they all work together? 30 seconds, Jack, go for it.
Okay, so think about Power Automate flows as single workflow automation. Perfect example is like PO processing. Then if you think about how when you'd use Copilots, they're to do jobs. So they can encompass multiple workflows like PO processing and helping me find my knowledge articles. So they can be chat-based and they can do, you know, help me find those articles as we just discussed and action at the same time. The good news is they work together. Power Automate is the actionability layer for Copilot Studio.
Jack, you want to know how much time?
I've pushed it. I think I'm going to say about 34 seconds.
30 seconds, exactly.
Oh, yes.
You passed them all. Congratulations. Thank you so much. You've been a great guest. The community appreciates it, I'm sure. And we have a feeling you will be back the next batch of questions that I'm sure they're going to have. So thank you once again.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you so much for tuning in to Season 2 of Demystifying. And if you happen to miss any of the previous questions, be sure to check them all out on the Dynamics 365 community on YouTube. While you're there, make sure you also check out, if you missed it, Season 1 of Demystifying, where we covered all things Copilot. And keep an eye out on the Microsoft Learns page as we continue adding content showing you how to do all the things that we discussed with agents and Copilot. Until then, we will see you at Season 3.